Every time the battle between the city state's attorney and the police commissioner seems to cool off, there's another twist. Today, the clerk of court is calling for police commissioner Fred Bealefeld to resign. No one else has stepped forward to echo that request, and tonight, Fred Bealefeld was very well received by neighborhood activists.
Mayor Stephanie Rawlings-Blake and Police Commissioner Fred Bealefeld joined citizens on patrol in Carrollton Ridge, where Bealefeld received a warm reception. The mayor expressed confidence in the commissioner despite the recent flap over his decision to display lawn signs in support of Greg Bernstein, a candidate for city state's attorney.
And the numbers speak for themselves. We have historic lows. We're lower than we were last year, and many significant numbers, particularly homicides and shootings. He's out here. He's a community-based policing advocate. He's out here with the community. You can see he's very well received.
I have an obligation to public safety in this city, and I'm going to do anything and everything I can to stay focused on that.
Bernstein's campaign signs disappeared from Bealefeld's lawn on Wednesday, 24 hours after incumbent state's attorney Patricia Jessamy called for an investigation into whether Bealefeld is using his position to campaign against her.
It will establish whether our police commissioner is a person of truth and veracity or not.
The mayor doesn't believe an investigation is necessary. We asked Bealefeld if he can keep up a productive working relationship with Jessamy after she publicly questioned his character.
That's what the people expect of me. That's what the mayor demands of me. And so that you can take from that what you will. I will do everything I can to make this city safe.
Now, Bealefeld declined to tell us tonight if the mayor was the one who asked him to take down Greg Bernstein's campaign signs. However, when we asked the mayor if she thought it was a bad idea for Bealefeld to put those signs out in the first place, she just smiled and told us that we live in a country that's supposed to support free speech. Reporting live downtown, I'm Carrie Cavanaugh, WBAL-TV 11 News.